Congratulations, graduates. You finished your degree, and now it's time to celebrate your achievement by participating in the time-honored tradition of commencement. One of the most visible traditions associated with commencement ceremonies is the wearing of regalia, which is the attire that signifies the different levels of achievement for each graduate. As we describe each level of regalia, our model will be wearing the regalia to demonstrate the proper wearing of each set. For bachelor candidates, you'll notice that the graduation gown has straight sleeves and a flat, square cap called a mortarboard with a colored tassel that signifies the discipline of the graduate. The UTA bookstore offers a custom bachelor's cap and gown set with sleeves that feature a royal blue satin edge with orange trim that signifies our school colors and a medallion zipper pull. However, a plain black gown with straight sleeves is also acceptable. Additional cords and stoles that represent academic achievement or membership in an honor society, fraternity, or sorority, or other organization may also be worn. Certain cords are available for purchase from the bookstore. Students who are members of an organization should contact their organization to inquire about other cords or stoles. Mortar boards have a skull cap that sits on top of your head, and the elastic band should be on the back of your head. If the cap isn't secure on your head, you should use bobby pins to secure it. For bachelor candidates, the tassel should be on the candidate's right side before the ceremony and will be moved to the left at the end of the ceremony. If you are decorating your cap, be sure that the tassel isn't secured in a way that would prevent you from being able to move your tassel. For master's candidates, you'll notice that the gown looks very different. This gown has longer, wing-like sleeves with no trim. While it may look unusual, this is the way that the sleeves are supposed to look. The UTA bookstore offers a custom master's cap and gown set with a gown that has a royal blue velvet stripe down the front. Additionally, the master's set also includes a master's hood with a colored velvet outer edge and an orange and white satin inner side. The velvet on the hood should match the color of the graduate's tassel and signifies their discipline. Occasionally, there is a mismatch of the hood color, and the graduate may need to exchange it for the correct color hood at the bookstore. A plain black gown with the wing-like sleeves is also acceptable so long as the appropriately colored master's hood is also worn. Like the bachelor candidates, master candidates also wear a mortarboard cap. For master's candidates, the tassel should be on the candidate's left side before the ceremony and will stay in that position. Only bachelor candidates move their tassels. While it is not as common, master's candidates may also wear cords or stoles. If worn, cords and stoles should be placed around the shoulders before the hood is placed. The master's hood should be placed with the velvet side showing and the satin side underneath. On most hoods, there is an elastic loop at the point of the front part of the hood. This may be attached to a button on the inside of the front of the gown near the top of the zipper. Like the master's gown, the master's hood also features a long wing-like appendage that hangs at the bottom of the back of the graduate. There is an additional button and loop that should be connected between the graduate's shoulders, and the velvet edge along the bottom of the back of the hood should be folded to show the orange and white satin. Any unfinished edges of the hood should be safely tucked into the back of the hood. Both bachelor's and master's candidates are encouraged to decorate their mortarboard caps and participate in the cap decorating contest that happens each semester. More information about the contest can be found on our commencement website. I hope this instructional video has given you the information you need to purchase the correct regalia set for your degree level and discipline. Here are two more suggestions for you to consider. 1. Please open your package as soon as you get it to confirm that you have the correct and complete set before you arrive at the commencement site, and that it fits. The UTA bookstore will work with you to correct any problems with your regalia, but please let them know as soon as you notice that there is a problem. 2. Please wear appropriate footwear on commencement day. There will be a lot of walking over various types of flooring, and we want to make sure that you are comfortable and safe as you participate in the ceremony.